So you might not remember this because it's been a minute since you like applied to our school, but do you remember the application process at all? Want to give any tips, to prospective students since you've done the process and been like accepted?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. So any advice I offer, this is just going to come off the top of my head from what I remember, because I had a whole semester in between. So the first thing, I know this is going to be super cliche, but be yourself. We want to the admissions committee, I believe, wants to see who you are as a person and what you have to offer to the school and the nursing profession. So being yourself is super duper cool and super awesome. Another recommendation I have is when choosing your references, choose people that know you well. So for myself, I chose my advisor that helped me like pick all my classes during my 4 years in undergrad, a research lab coordinator whom I worked with for around 3 years, and a professor in my department whom I've taken multiple classes with. So each of them offered a different perspective of me, not only as a student, but also as an individual, and basically knew my aspirations to become a nurse early on, and basically catered to that, I believe, when speaking about me. Hopefully, I'm not sure, but essentially choose people that know you well and know your goals and know your aspirations. Another thing I know, I don't know if this is true, Caitlin, but I hear that there's a video essay.
There is now there is,
Awesome. Yeah, so when you do your personal statement and video essay, those are going to be super important for the admissions committee to get to know you outside of the classroom and your extracurriculars. So I would say take a big advantage of that. Another piece of information is get started on your app early. That way you have enough time to make your edits and you feel confident with your application. You can always go back, rearrange, and you have that time to do so, and it's not as stressful as applying last minute. Lastly, I highly encourage to learn more about your program and institution. For Hopkins, we have a chat and chew Monday through Friday at noon from yeah Monday through Friday to 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, where you get to meet with an admissions officer and more about your designated program and interest, and they can help guide you with the resources we have at on campus and all the cool stuff that we have to offer here at Hopkins.
Yeah, that's and thank you. That's amazing. Like, I know it's been a minute, and the application is a little different now because you had to do two essays, and now we have a video essay. So thank you. So okay, let's get into the fun stuff. Let's talk about your first semester. How are your classes? Do you want to talk about your clinicals and stuff?
Sure. So for my first semester, I arrived here in August and basically, moved in and stuff and got settled. So my first semester was one of my favorites because you're learning the foundational information to become a successful Hopkins nurse. So the classes you have, and this is off the top of my head, pathophysiology, foundations of nursing practice, common health alterations, health assessment, and community outreach, I believe. I think I hit all of them. And it's important to note that collectively, those classes are 17 credits. So that may seem overwhelming at first. However, if anything, the first semester teaches you how to effectively manage your time or effective time management, which will be very, very helpful down the line in your nursing careers. And with your support system here at Hopkins, through your professors and going to office hours, study groups with friends, and tutoring through the TLC, which is the Teaching Learning Collaborative, you will be successful without a doubt. So really building those connections with your professors and reaching out to certain resources really help alleviate some of the stressors that may come with the amount of coursework. And as long as you follow that formula, I would say you will be in great hands without a doubt. Did you mention clinical, Caitlin? Am I wrong?
No, so do you want to talk about clinicals?
Yeah, so that was my favorite part of the week. So my clinical was Friday. It was an evening clinical. It went from 3 to 11, and my clinical was at the Johns Hopkins Hospital where I worked on Meyer 8. So Meyer 8 was a med surg unit, or also known as medical surgery unit. And so I saw all different types of illnesses and basically diseases, and basically anything from cardiovascular complications to neuro complications and everything in between. And I love the patients I worked with on the floor. And I worked with around 2 to 3 patients towards the end of my clinical, which is kind of a lot when you're thinking of starting. But once you like start working with one patient, and then the next week you work with two, and the next week you work with three, you get used to it, and you get to learn those assessments you use in health assessment. You get to make those connections that you learn in pathophysiology and foundations, and you get to combine all those together, and at the end of the week, use them in your clinical setting to help document for your patient and help your nurse out on the floor. And in terms of my clinical group and clinical instructor, I absolutely love them. Still friends with all my clinical friends today. And clinicals tend to be small. They tend to be around 6 to 8 people per group. So you get quality time with your instructor, and you feel confident when going into patients' rooms and practicing your skills on your patients and those assessments that you learned during the week. And your instructor always knows, like, you know, what you're learning that week. So you won't be expected to do these crazy assessments that, you know, you haven't learned yet, because they don't expect you to. So they meet you where you are, regardless of what your background is, or if you have any experience coming into the program, which is something that I really, really, you know, liked about the program too, is that they meet you where you are, and then they help build upon the foundation that you have, and they supplement it with these awesome courses and these awesome clinical settings. So yeah, that's what I have to say about my clinical and how much I enjoyed it. Like I said, favorite part of the week, always probably will be my favorite part of the week. So yeah.
You're doing a new clinical starting this semester too. Has that started yet?
Yes, that has started. I'm also working on a medical surge telemetry unit this semester.
Oh, very nice.
So I'm getting all of that experience.
Perfect. Ahead. So I know you're a very busy student with other things, mm-hmm. but did you join any clubs or have any volunteer experience during your first semester, like, as well?
Yeah. So during the pandemic. So I'm going to talk a little bit about volunteering. So during the COVID-19 Omicron surge, basically the hospital basically sent an email to the School of Nursing, and the School of Nursing sent an email to us as students to help volunteer during the pandemic due to either shortened staff or, like, you know, not having enough beds, et cetera, et cetera. So I, you know, came back from break early and basically helped volunteer during the pandemic at the hospital on certain floors, taking vitals, making sure that, you know, the patients were doing okay while the nurses were, you know, floating to other units. I also helped remotely as well, answering calls and doing work on the computer virtually. So there was also that opportunity as well. So this is my, like, first time volunteering, and I'm looking forward to volunteering more in the semester, because, you know, that's what I, you know, perceive myself as a nurse, is, you know, taking those volunteer opportunities, making sure that, you know, my community is being supported the way that, you know, I believe it should be supported, especially, like, during the, in the hospital, and the surge of Omicron during the pandemic. That's, like, the volunteer stuff I did. In terms of clubs, I recently joined the Critical Care Interest Group, which is, like, really awesome. I really had an awesome opportunity to visit them during club fair, because I am currently right now, and this may change during your program, is you might have a change of what you might want to do in terms of your specialty. So I came in thinking that, you know, I wanted to be a nurse practitioner, and that quickly changed when I got a shadowing opportunity at Ziad, which is where the operating rooms are. And I got to, you know, shadow a nurse anesthetist. And that was really, really awesome. And I really got to see, you know, how the critical care, you know, basically works in that setting. So I'm really interested about pursuing that, but also keeping an open mind, because you never know during your time at Hopkins in the program what might change your mind. Because I have a complex rotation next semester. I have peds and OB the following semester before I choose my synthesis. So you get to work in all these different settings and have these really robust opportunities to, you know, figure out where you want to specialize in. So that's in terms of clubs, volunteer, shadowing, and any clinical experience I might have. And I believe my job as an admission ambassador is also very fun. I get to, you know, go on the office. I come twice a week and basically help the admissions office with, you know, either chat and chew behind the scenes, help talk to prospective students via email or via Zoom or via phone, tell them about the program. And during open houses, I give tours of the building, which is also really awesome. We I believe the last year, opened up a new section of the building, which is very spectacular and beautiful. And I'm like, you know, still finding new places to study in it. So yeah, that's my experience thus far in terms of extracurricular opportunities at the School of Nursing.
Wow, you're just so busy with school and everything. How do you juggle it all? But that's amazing. Yeah. Is there anything you want to add, Shawn, to our prospective students before we close for the day?
Yeah, I would just say, you know, be yourself when applying and really take the opportunity to learn more about your designated program and learn more about the school. And we are always here to answer any questions. I believe that, you know, the chat and chews are super helpful. I think I went to them every day, Kaitlyn, when I was a prospective.
I remember seeing you in there. You became my buddy.
Yeah. So like got to learn a lot about the school and, you know, what opportunities awaited me when I chose to decide to go there. And so that in all, you know, other than getting a planner, which they do provide at orientation, which is super helpful when managing your coursework. Other than getting a planner, reaching out, and, you know, being yourself. And I think that's all. And I'm looking forward to welcoming you all to the Hopkins community.
Yeah, great. Yeah, so thanks for joining us today, Shawn, and look forward to our next video to see how Shawn does in his second semester into his third semester. Thanks, everyone.
Bye, everyone.